Impact weather here on a Wednesday morning. We've got more rain showers expected. In fact, a steadier rain late this afternoon into tonight, perhaps even a rumble of thunder. Temperatures today are going to once again climb into the 70s, but it's going to be muggy, and we really don't lose that for a couple more days. Here's the view from above. We've got a frontal boundary approaching. This red line is the forecasted track of Hurricane Lee as it comes northward up toward Nova Scotia. But before that arrives on Saturday, we've got this frontal boundary to contend with. The rain today into tonight. Tomorrow, hey, a little bit of improvement. Slightly cooler temperatures, only a couple of degrees. More importantly, less humid air mass, which will allow for some sunshine. Yeah, partly sunny skies tomorrow, and Friday right now looks good. Of course, clouds from the hurricane will begin to overspread the area as well. So the hurricane is beginning to make that long-awaited turn toward the north, and by this afternoon, forecast to weaken to a Category 2 storm system. By the time it gets up in our region, it's looking to be a Category 1, but transitioning to a non-tropical system. Therefore, the wind field is likely to be expanding. So although the center is likely to cross up over Nova Scotia, we are still going to feel some of the wind impact on, on its western edge. Chance for hurricane force winds is very low, but if we look at the chance for tropical storm force winds, which are 40 miles per hour or greater, you can see the mid coast and the down east coast are likely to experience those. In fact, if anything, the Hurricane Center has said these numbers, the likelihood may be a tad on the low side. So the takeaway here from impacts for Lee, for the time being, high surf and large waves and dangerous rip currents along the coastline. Offshore waves of 15 to 20 feet, bays could see, 6 to 10 foot seas. A large and slow moving storm system as it crosses the Gulf of Maine, and those tropical storm force winds of 40 to 60 miles per hour along the coastline. We'll talk more about the potential for power outages and more about the surf and timing of all this over the next couple of days. For now, let's check the 8-day forecast. Enjoy your Wednesday, everyone.